Hi, dear humans. Hi, truthful friends of the humanity. If you're a friend of humanity, then you must be a good friend to yourself, considering that you are a human. So if you're not, well, then you probably belong in this group or in this elite clique of notorious and really unorganic liars. Today I'll make you a news. I'll tell you the way how they're telling the so-called truth. Maybe you're not familiar with Joe Dirt and Mika, the, you know, a son of the very nasty and deceased Brzezinski man, who was pretty much shaping the political scene and war scene through the last 50 years through every American president but Donald Trump. So it really has to party before really Trump put his foot into the White House. So title: Junk Food for Programmed Mind and Fake News Media Liars. Yeah, we all kind of get exposed to junk food, eating hamburgers, chips, you know, fast food, which is absolutely equal to junk food. Sometimes the processed food in the so-called organic stores, you have been fed a lie. So they're selling you fake, organic, very ill and processed food. Same as in the news. And these creatures are actually, I don't know, like a family-oriented liar. So they cannot change their attitude no matter what. So as a father, so as that's this silly daughter, or as Scarborough's father and mother with a different last name. So this is his only stage name. So don't get too carried about finding or not finding anything about him. So Joe Scarborough, he just borrowed a scar. Scar means cut. A place where he can infuse his poison and dirt. Mika Brzezinski's father taught her well, yet she's losing her cool. She has no idea what to say next when Trump refused to go down as per their predictions. Well, it's quite an opposite story. And my apology to people who have no idea what these two creatures are, Mika Brzezinski and Joe Scarborough. They're having a 8 o'clock MSNBC show in the morning. It's called Morning Show with Joe or something like with the Joe Dirt. And they just pretty much inventing gossiping like crap that you cannot believe. And what's the very common habit in American, you know, modern civilization of watching TV and watching soap operas, watching like a really fake news and eating it, like, you know, while you're eating your hamburger and chips at the same time. So these kind of informations become a very low quality food for your brain. Not be able to develop anywhere further from their depiction of the situation. They never dare to touch any of the informations. They are real. They are very, very important for American people. And for the world people, that Trump is truly the man of his word. And he's doing everything he can with a lot of, you know, discomforts coming into his direction from FBI, CIA, Congress, Democratic, you know, shills and trolls and online, like, who are they to think to tell anybody, like sovereign being like Trump is, to stop using Twitter? Because on Twitter he can put whatever he thinks. So if Twitter wants to twiddle down with the viewership or what he's posting or what he's deleting, and then use it for some kind of sinister approaches to get certain FISA orders, you know, to spy on him even more. I mean, why have to spy on Trump? He's so transparent in everything what he's doing and what he's saying and what he's actually thinking. Well, he's a very wise, transparent man. He'll just tell you what he wanna tell you. And when he tells you something, he knows exactly why he's telling you. So it's not like these blabbers, they are just going around and finding a way to try to really assassinate Trump's character, plus some of the stupid so-called actors or comedians. They are really not funny at all. They are posing with a beheaded Trump's like a doll head. I mean, gruesome. So this is okay to put on TV, but to say the word fuck and they just bleep, and then you say fuck and then they bleep again. I mean, what the fuck these things are thinking? So beheading your president is okay, right? Publicly, and then posting it like everywhere. Yet if you tell the fuck the fake media, it's not okay. It's not so politically correct. So who's shaping this stupid and stupidly fucking politic? Creatures like father of this and father of this Joe DiMaggio, you know, mafia guy. We absolutely forgot as humanity to use our brain. We just utilize it as a pre-programmed tool that will just go and eat this shit off the really junk food, junk news. It's not even a fake news anymore, it's junk. It's actually, you hurt after that. For the fake news, you can say, okay, I'm hearing something and you're discerning. Okay, so just like throw it away, you don't even bother. But with these creatures, you're actually consuming it daily because they are pounding on you every single second. For 24/7, CNN is reverberating same old lie, and just they are hoping it will become truth, yet it will not. This is why Fox and WikiLeaks, Julian Assange, are doing everything to demise these creatures. And it's not, let's say, so smooth. It's not so easy. But what you can do, maybe what if you see what Hannity is doing now, what Tucker is doing, what Laura Ingraham is doing, they're actually making fun of these clowns, these ridiculous, like they're not even clowns. Clowns you can laugh at. On these guys, you can even cry for them how stupid they are. What you say about Joe the Dirt, I mean, this is a beautiful poster that I found online, saying that nobody believes him, he cheated everybody, that only Mika is the one as promised bride to be, that the only one who believes in him, in all his lies, or maybe her lies. So what I've heard, that he was born as a girl. So he put an implant of the fake penis and make his asshole a bit bigger so he can fit all of these brooms and sticks and all the things that he's hiding there, that he will start slapping people and feeding them with a really shitty lies. And she's not she. She's it. She's like it and he's she. All together they come as shit. So this is what people are watching in America. And for the time being, I can only request that these kind of creatures disappear, go off the air, because the stupid junkies or food junkies or this, you know, very bad food junkies that majority of Americans were before Trump started coming in and doing the cleanup, they cannot turn this off because they rather listen or hearing a gossip about what high heel Trump's wife is not wearing or wearing or anything like to this extent, rather than what is the executive order that Trump signed and what this order, executive order, will bring every freaking stolen money from American people back to America. So how this is possible? Simply because he took all of the corporate theft ever happened. All of the political and charity foundations, Clinton Foundation, Gates Foundation, you'll get the numbers. And this is not peanuts. This is in gazillions of dollars. Quadrillions of dollars. Three zeros more than trillion. So 12 zeros in total will be returned to American people only. And it will spread and trickle all this so-called safe haven, which are not haven, this is like a place of hell where they were hiding the money. And now what they're trying to do, some of this money, they have to wash it out. So what they're doing, they're dumping it, not in a Bitcoin, but in Bitcoin Cash, Bitcoin Gold. And they're trying to do the same shitty manipulations they were ever doing with the fiat currency because nobody noticed. Now with the Bitcoin, everybody sees what these creatures were doing. Suddenly, dollar just deflating so much that it can fit in one Bitcoin. $20,000 can fit in one Bitcoin. Wait for the next couple of months, probably after March. I mean, I really bless the old the beings who bought quarter, you know, tenth of the Bitcoin. You will be millionaires. Just watch and enjoy. Don't trade it, don't sell it, don't exchange it for anything else yet. Keep the Bitcoin. If you want to do some, let's say, extra other cryptocurrency, stick for now with Ethereum, ETH, stick with Dogecoin, DOGE, stick with Ion. Just buy, mine, keep it. It will not cost you anything, not even electricity on your computer. It has to sit on your computer, nowhere else. Based on this, that's why these creatures don't want to even mention a Bitcoin. Rare ones, and this is not rare, but RT is doing it for like many years now. When they start doing RT America, Ruptly and RT, they're really worldwide, really truthful network. One of the real true warriors of this media war that it was going around so much. Another little note. Today I received an official email from YouTube that they are closing my channel because I don't have enough views. I said, all right. Because I was very inquisitive. Every time I do the video, they slap me like a fine that I have to actually... Whatever I'm using, it's not legal, so they can monetize my videos to somebody else. And it's always some other, whatever, fake corporation or entity, they're using my videos. And they're playing with this, are they going to post it, where are they going to post it, which country can see it. So, absolutely like ludicrous. Yet, I think this was their only way out, because they would not like what they're going to receive from me in the terms of really legal charges for deception, for stealing, because this is what they've done. They stole 1,000 videos of mine, more, let's say, on the previous channel that completely they closed it. Yet it's not veil. I have alternatives everywhere. So just to let you know how this fake media is not only on CNN or MSNBC, it's on internet. It's through the YouTube, it's through the Google, through the programming, through the really the way they deciding what you have to see or what you can see, what you can hear. So who are these they? I'm questioning often and always coming to the solution that this is not they, it is it. It is a freaking scared dark AI entity that is residing somehow in this obscure network that created many of these corporations. And as much we start pressing these corporations, as Trump is doing with the Twitter, with the Google, with the Facebook, to me, if you read detailed what he did with the his executive order, the very last one on the 21st of December 2017, he changed the tapestry of the corporate world. All this stolen money is going to be returned. So a good news, as I got this as well from Britain, they start changing the colors of the passports based off another truth warrior, Christopher Mark. Really blessings to him and his, you know, really persistence to show us a right way through judicial approach, how to get really rid of all this constant theft. Now it's a time that we start harvesting these freaking corporations and we start actually receiving what was always ours. So we'll receive all the sweat, energy and time spent working for these creatures or whatever, these entities, and we'll receive it back in a full value. So be it.